In this series, we're going to be talking about how practicing self-love in 12 really specific ways actually helps you to attract romantic love. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about the specific self-love tip number 3, which is how you can stop scaring yourself with doomsday scenarios about your love life. Love. I'm Carisa Montooth, 6th generation certified energy healer and love coach, creator of the Soul Love Method course, helping high vibe single women heal their hearts and attract love. And today we are going to be talking about how to stop scaring yourself so that you can focus on healing your heart and attracting your happy, committed, healthy relationship. So, if you have been hearing a lot about self-love and you're not really sure what it means to practice self-love, then this series is for you. And if you're a little bit unsure what the connection is between self-love and attracting romantic love, then this series is definitely for you. So Louise Hay was the queen of self-love. She wrote tons of books about it, including You Can Heal Your Life and Mirror Work, which is actually a 21-day self-love healing program. And I've got links for you to both of those books in the description. But what we're doing in this series is we're looking at these 12 specific self-love practices, and we're understanding how they help us when our specific goal is to attract romantic love. And today we're especially zeroing in on what to do when you're preoccupied with really fearful thoughts about your future and your love life. You know, thoughts like, I'm going to be alone forever. You know, I'm going to die alone. Nobody wants, you know, to be with me. I'm not worthy of love. You know, I've got to do so much to get ready to be loved. I'm too broken to be loved. I'm too much of a tough case to heal and have love. All these kinds of thoughts. We're going to talk about what to do to release those kinds of fearful thoughts so that you can stay in this flow of self-love and have this good, happy, magnetic energy to bring in the love that you deserve. So first, let's talk about why you need to actually quell these fearful thoughts. The first reason is because when you focus on fears about the future, it makes it really hard to see and experience the good that's in your present right now. So when you're focused on fearing the loneliness in the future, or fearing like a dismal kind of a love life, you're not able to see the other forms of love that you're already receiving. You're not able to see love that you're receiving from family and friends. You're not able to appreciate it and experience it and really soak it up and be with that love because you're too focused on this fear of, but I'm going to be alone in the future and all these kinds of things. Another thing is really from a metaphysical perspective, and that's that we know that what we focus on is actually magnified and increased in our experience. So focusing on fear increases more things to be fearful about. It gives us more in our life to actually be fearful about. The fears multiply. The next reason we want to really squash these fearful thoughts as best as we can is because focusing on fear interrupts your manifesting mojo. And that's true in love and in life. So it really takes you out of your power as a co-creator with the divine. And it moves your soulmate actually away from you in energy. It makes you less magnetic in energy unless you're trying to attract a soulmate who is also focused on fearful thoughts. So that's a really good reason to try to release these fears, to be willing to let go of these fears. The other thing is, fearful thoughts about your future don't usually come true anyway. So it's really a waste of time and energy to focus on them. And that's time and energy that you could be using to build the future you want instead of fearing a future that probably isn't going to happen. And just so you know, every single private client that I have had, and I've worked with so many women, but they have all started out with these fears about maybe my soulmate's not really out there. Maybe there really isn't one person, you know, out there for me. Maybe there's not really someone for everyone. Maybe it's just my destiny to be alone. You know, maybe that's just for other people, you know. And, you know, 87% of my clients were in happy, healthy, committed relationships within 3 to 6 months of us working together, because that's a lot of the work that we did, was clearing out these fears on a deep energetic level. So what can you do to actually be able to break this habit of scaring yourself? Because it does become a habit. First it's a thought, then it's a thought that you engage in really often, and then that becomes a habit, and then the more that we're thinking of it, the more it becomes a law of our lives. So what can we do to break it? Well, the first thing that we can do is we can start to tune in to our bodies and what are our body's signs of fear and anxiety. Maybe for you, you notice that your breathing gets a little bit more shallow. You might notice that, you know, maybe you flinch more often or you startle really easily. You might notice that your hands get clammy or something like that. Maybe they get colder. You might notice that start to have like your vision gets kind of narrowed, and you're just in this your heart might be beating faster, you know, those kinds of things. You might start to notice those kinds of things, and when you notice those things, you'll know that you're in a fear response, that you're not able to really see the full scope of what's going on. You're having a fear response, and you can't function at your top level when you're in this response. So when you notice those signs, what can you do? The next thing you can do is you can begin some deep breathing, and you can scan your environment to confirm that you're safe, and then you can actually affirm safety for yourself. So what does that mean? We don't want to sit and say, I am safe, I am safe, I am safe, because when you don't feel safe and you just sit and say, I am safe, I am safe, I am safe, you're actually triggering resistance, because every time you say, I am safe, you're going to hear internally, no, you're not. So it's just going to make you more, it's just going to make you feel more unsafe and more fearful. So the best thing that you can do when you're feeling really fearful and you start to get into this spiral of fearful thoughts about your future, you can sit with your back against a wall, because your body, when your back is against a wall, your body feels less vulnerable, because it knows that no one can approach you or no one can attack you from behind. And it's just a signal to your body physically that it is safe and it can begin to calm down. The next thing that you can do is with your out breath, just say the word safe. So you breathe in, safe, safe. Or you can breathe out and say safety. And again, we don't want to say, I am safe, because generally, if we're not feeling particularly safe, you're just going to trigger those resistance thoughts, thoughts that are like the devil's advocate side of yourself that just is going to say whatever is contrary to what's going on. So that's a really good way to help your body help you feel more safe. Another thing that you can do is you can shift your thoughts to gratitude, because what you're wanting to do is you want to connect to a spiritual practice that brings you into the present. And nothing really does that the way that gratitude does. It's exactly what gratitude does. It wrenches your fears, it wrenches your attention away from, you know, phantom fears about the future, and it brings them into this beautiful bounty of the present and what's going on in your life right now, which is a really important and powerful shift. And then you can see things like the love of family and friends and pets and good health and enough money and even being able to be grateful for the opportunity to evolve, which is something to be grateful for. And if you feel like your fear or your anxiety are starting to really get out of control, get professional help taking care of that. Talk to a counselor. Talk to someone about that who has the skill to help you with fear and with anxiety. Don't keep trying to go it alone. You know, you are worth investing in. You are worth taking care of. So now I want to hear from you high vibe ladies. How does your body respond when you are in fear mode, when you're scaring yourself about these thoughts about the future and I'm going to be alone and all of these kinds of things? Do you actually find that you access those fears and that you are most of the time consciously aware of them, or are you always kind of pushing them down and there's this sort of sense of dread in the background? You know, because that's sometimes what happens for us too, is we don't consciously acknowledge those fears. We just feel this vague sense of dread in the background. And so we distract ourselves by doing other things and not focusing on it and addressing it and clearing it out. Let me know in the comments. And if you liked this video, then remember to like and subscribe. And also remember that self-love is the best love. So love you first, love you best, and all other kinds of love will flow to you. Take care.